If you want to write clean code, you must obey these five golden rules, and they are the golden rules of the solid principle. Alex here from Rebeloper.com. If you do want to write clean code and learn how I do it, make sure to smash that subscribe button. Let's open up Xcode and let's dive in. Writing clean code is nothing new. You most probably want to do that already. But what are the guidelines? What do you have to actually do to write clean code? Where today we are going to dive deep into the five golden rules that I follow each and every day. So it is all about solid principles. And because these solid principles are five, I'm going to create a whole series around this. So make sure to check out the link in the description for the whole playlist. I will also make sure that I will tell you where you can find the next video at the end of the video. So make sure that you follow along and take a look at this video till the end. Now, before we dive into the solid principles, let me remind you about Dev Factory. Now, what is Dev Factory? Well, if you've been around on my channel, then you know that Dev Factory is a 60-minute Zoom call with me. If you haven't been around my channel, well, welcome. Hopefully you will subscribe after this video. Now, Dev Factory is a 60-minute Zoom call with me where you can ask me about Swift UI or your bug in your code or whatever iOS development issues you have. Now, Dev Factory is at rebeloper.com/mentoring. I am looking forward for you to check that out, and hopefully we will see you there. Now, let's just jump into our keynote for today, and that is solid five golden rules of clean code. Now, if you are following me along then on this channel, then you know that I do like clean code. I'm a really advocate of clean, reusable, and all of that stuff. Clean code is my rules. And what is actually solid? Well, solid is one of the most popular sets of design principles in object-oriented software development. Now, that is for object-oriented software development, but as a rule of thumb, they do come in handy for other types of software development. Let's just go forward. The principles are a subset of many principles promoted by American software engineer and instructor Robert C. Martin. This was first introduced in his 2000 paper, Design Principles and Design Patterns. Now, this is kind of the background here. You don't really have to know about this, but you want to know about Robert C. Martin, Uncle Bob, as they say. These five principles are kind of the object-oriented principles, but as you will see, they can be applied for all of like other types of environments. Now, SOLID is the acronym, was introduced later around 2004 by Michael Features. And what is that acronym is about? So what does the SOLID stand for? It's an acronym for the following five design principles. And these are the five design principles I will go deep into in the following videos. So make sure to check out the link in the description for the whole playlist. So S-O-L-I-D. S stands for single responsibility principle. And that we will tackle in the very next video. Open-close principle, LISKOV substitution principle, interface segregation principle, and finally, dependency inversion principles. These are the five that I live by each and every day. Now, why SOLID? Well, the SOLID principle helps you solve the main problems of bad architecture. Bad architecture, I mean like really bad code. Like you just open it up and say, whoa, what's going on here? I don't really understand what's going on. So these are the three main key points that I like to point out around architecture, around good architecture, bad architecture. So fragility. Now, what is fragility? Well, for example, we are unable to change because it may break unexpected parts. You could write code that is working, but if you change something, it will break a lot of things, or maybe just one thing, but it will break some things unexpectedly. So you don't really expect that thing to be changed by your change. And of course, that change might break some things. Immobility, unable to reuse because of tightly coupled dependencies. Now, I do love the antidote for immobility, and that is really these nice small groups of code, like classes should do just one thing. That's why I just create all of these frameworks, for example. I do like the antidote for immobility. Now, rigidity. A single change affects several parts of the project. Again, this comes back to kind of the immobility, but it also adds a kind of a domino effect where you just change one thing and you might expect it to be changed only there, but because of some bad architecture decisions, it will change several parts of the code, and most probably they will be unexpected. So these are kind of the three things that Solid solves: fragility, immobility, and rigidity. Now, the principles established practices that lend to developing software with consideration for maintaining and extending as the project goes. Now, this is kind of the main point here. You could write code that it's working okay, but maintaining it and extending it, it's a whole other different level. Now, that's why we want to use Solid. Now, let's take a look at what the first letter of Solid is, and that is single responsibility principle. And that's stating that there should never be more than one reason for a class to change. Now, these kind of definitions, they may be encrypted, and you may be not really realizing what it does or why it's like that. Make sure to follow along the tutorials on the playlist. But I will just give some sort of definition and explanation in this video also. So, single responsibility principle. This comes from Wikipedia. In some of his talks, he, Robert C. Martin, also argues that the principle is in particular about roles or actors. For example, while they might be the same person, the role of an accountant is different from a database administrator. Hence, each module should be responsible for each role. Now, think of it like you have a class, and then you have many, many roles in them. Like, let's say, three roles in them, or responsibilities. That's not the way to do it. That will break the single responsibility principle, which in turn kind of, I do know that it's kind of like breaking the maintenance and extension for this code, because I have experience in it. But basically, you want to think about this. You want to have one role and one role only for your entities. Entities meaning classes, structs, all of that. Okay, so next up comes open-close principle. Entities should be open for extension, but closed for modification. Now, this is an interesting one, because usually, now, like entities, let's see, a class is closed since it may be compiled, stored in library, baselined, and used by a client classes. So it's kind of closed. Okay, we created the class, and now we can just use it. But it also is open, since any new class may use it as a parent, adding new features. When a descendant class is defined, there is no need to change the original or to disrupt its clients. So this is the main point here. You don't want to modify the original when you are extending it. Okay, but we will talk about this in depth in the following tutorials. L stands for LISKOV substitution principle. Objects should be replaced with instances of their subclasses without altering the behavior. Now, this is interesting, and this really small example clears it all. If S is a subtype of T, then objects of type T may be replaced with objects of type S without altering any of the desirable properties of the program. Now, again, this is kind of cryptic, but go ahead and take a look at it. Read it a few more times and you will understand it. Of course, we will just have there our example. I stands for interface segregation principle. A client should not be forced to implement an interface that it doesn't use. Now, this is straightforward. Clients should not be forced to depend upon interfaces, like in Swift protocols that they do not use. For example, if you have a protocol that has multiple functions that are needed and you're creating a class that one of those functions is not needed by that protocol and you do want to adhere to that protocol, then you want to chunk that protocol into two. So that class should not be dependent on the unused protocol. No code should be forced to depend on methods it does not use. Yeah, basically it states it. Okay, and finally, we have dependency inversion principle. Now, this is kind of the hardest rule to kind of wrap your head around. It says depend on abstractions, not on concretions. Abstractions should not depend on details. Details should depend on abstractions. A good example I will show you in the videos that are upcoming. Now, again, these principles establish practices that lend to developing software with consideration for maintaining and extending as the project grows. Now, I wanted to emphasize this. You want to write code that is maintainable and extendable. And we will get to the explanation of the fifth one, don't worry. Just make sure that you follow along. Now, although the solid principles apply to any object-oriented design, they can also form a core philosophy for methodologies such as agile development or adaptive software development. So every developer should understand all these principles as it is a key concept for any software engineer. Now, kind of the explanation for dependency inversion principle, high-level modules should not depend upon low-level modules. Both should depend on abstractions. Now, most probably you are doing it like high-level modules are depending on low-level modules, but both should depend on abstractions. Abstractions should not depend on details. Details should depend on abstractions. And actually, abstractions are kind of protocols in Swift. Now, what is up next? Well, we are going to tackle the single responsibility principle. There should never be more than one reason for a class to change. And make sure to watch this video till the end, so I will let you know where you can find this video where I talk in depth about single responsibility principle. Now, if you do like these types of videos, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can meet me on a 60-minute Zoom call where you can just show me your bug in your code. I can help you with that, or Swift UI. If you do want to learn about that, I'm also available for that. So it is at rebeloper.com/mentoring. These are the five principles that I live by and write code by each and every day. Now, if you do like these solid principles and want to learn more, check out the first video about the solid principles, and that is the single responsibility principle right over here. Now, if you do want to take a look at the whole playlist, check it out right over here, all about the five golden rules for clean code. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.